subscribe to our YouTube channel Short and Detention Legal Matters, but never forget to hit on like icon and share with your friends. Thank you.
Ready, start. By no means it is suggested that whenever such charge of rape is made where the victim is a child, it has to be treated as a gospel truth and the accused person has to be convicted. We have already discussed above the manner in which testimony of the prosecutrix is to be examined and analyzed in order to find out the truth therein and to ensure that deposition of the victim is trustworthy. At the same time, after taking all due precautions which are necessary when it is found that the prosecution version is worth believing, the case is to be dealt with all sensitivity that is needed in such cases. In such a situation, one has to take stock of the realities of life as well. Various studies show that in more than 80% cases of such abuses, perpetrators have acquaintance with the victims who are not strangers. The danger is more within than outside. Most of the time, acquaintance rapes when the culprit is a family member are not even reported for various reasons not difficult to fathom. The strongest among those is the fear of attracting social stigma. Another deterring factor which many times prevent such victims or their families to lodge a complaint is that they find whole process of criminal justice system extremely intimidating, coupled with absence of victim protection mechanism. Therefore, time is ripe to bring about significant reforms in the criminal justice system as well. Equally, there is also a dire need to have a survivor-centric approach towards victims of sexual violence, particularly the children, keeping in view the traumatic, long-lasting effects on such victims. After thorough analysis of all relevant and attendant factors, we are of the opinion that none of the grounds on which the High Court has cleared the respondent has any merit. By now, it is well settled that the testimony of a victim in cases of sexual offences is vital, and unless there are compelling reasons which necessitate looking for corroboration of a statement, the courts should find no difficulty to act on the testimony of the victim of a sexual assault alone to convict the accused. No doubt her testimony has to inspire confidence. Seeking corroboration to a statement before relying upon the same as a rule in such cases would literally amount to adding insult to injury. The deposition of the prosecutrix has thus to be taken as a whole. Needless to reiterate that the victim of rape is not an accomplice and her evidence can be acted upon without corroboration. She stands at a higher pedestal than an injured witness does. If the court finds it difficult to accept her version, it may seek corroboration from some evidence which lends assurance to her version. To insist on corroboration, except in the rarest of rare cases, is to equate one who is a victim of the lust of another with an accomplice to a crime, thereby insult womanhood. it would be adding insult to injury to tell a woman that her claim of rape will not be believed unless it is corroborated in material particulars, as in the case of an accomplice to a crime. Stop.